Manchester playground is a popular spot, not just for children to play, but for people to shoot up and leave dirty needles behind.
EMS officer Chris Hickey is on a walk around, finding time during his shift to walk around places like Stevens Park in Manchester, trying to find discarded needles before children do.
What we look for is I look for the paraphernalia. I look for the cooking spoons, the household spoons they would have used to cook the heroin in, pieces or parts of syringes, whether it be the needle from the tip or the complete syringe with the needle. I found them right here where we are in the playground area. I found them in the parking lot, and I found them in the dugouts.
The dugout where Little League teams will soon sit is a prime shoot-up spot.
I'm just looking up here to make sure they just didn't put it up high.
He'll check under the bench for needles that can hold drugs and disease, inside empty cans, even the dumpsters, especially this time of year.
We get a lot of calls like right after winter, right after plowing, and the snow starts to melt because everything's in piles.
This is what he picked up during today's shift.
There are times we find them still loaded with product. You know, the brown liquid. I take my kids here. It's supposed to be someplace safe that they can run around and be kids, and, you know, heaven forbid they get a needle stuck in their foot or their hand.
That's why he's watching the progress of the needle exchange bill in New Hampshire.
But with the needle exchange program, it's a big thing for public safety, but it's certainly something that needs to have a community conversation.
And first responders are concerned solving the opioid crisis might not be the end. They're bracing for a dramatic rise in bloodborne illnesses like hepatitis C and HIV, all from dirty needles. In Manchester, Jean Mackin, WMUR News 9.